Thank you. chair of the music department here at Otterbein University. Thank you all for coming out for this wonderful. This visit possible these days with Libby Larson. I want to thank also the Westerwolde Fund for helping us supporting this concert and also supporting the commission that you'll hear in a minute, the premiere of a new choral work. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to Libby Larson, who will tell us more.
Thank you so much. I just climbed up on a box because you could only see me from my nose up. I am so deeply honored to be here in this room with you this evening, celebrating our lives through the music making that we are all engaged in, performing, creating, listening to, giving our energy back and forth, all around something that is deeply positive, and that is making music. I have some thank yous. I want to thank Dr. Gail Walker and Dr. Nick Ross and Dr. Jennifer Merkowitz for all of the planning that has gone into my 4 days here in the community. It's really stunning. And of course, to Vernon L. Pack for his vision and his generosity in making it possible for us to just come together in community, sharing our thoughts, our ideas, our creativity, our vision for life as it can be. It's quite humbling to be here in the midst of all this goodwill and talent. And I just want to thank you. We've been rehearsing, you can probably tell. We've been rehearsing the last couple of weeks. We've been doing it by Zoom, which I can tell you is really hard to do. it's really, really hard. And we have been throwing buckets of goodwill at each other via the internet, just waiting for the day when we can be in the room, which we are tonight. I could probably talk for 6 hours about the music, so I won't do that. I'll let the music speak for itself. But I did want to give you my definition of composing. I don't know what your definition of composing music is, but for all the years that I have been privileged to just make sound, and say, what do you think? That's what I do. It's a crazy way to spend a life, but it's made me really sure that what composition is for me is making an order of sound in time and space in order to communicate what it's like to be alive. That's what it is. There are pitches, and there are rhythms, and there are notes, and there are mythologies, and there's a performance practice and all those things. But what it really is reaching into the air, which is infinite. It's infinite possibility in the air, and everything that we are spiritually and sonically and perceptually is in the air, and it's my privilege. Sometimes it doesn't feel that way, but it's also my hard work. But it really is my privilege to accept the role of steward, to try to make pieces that feel and sound like music, that reach into our souls. And I don't know how it reaches into your soul. I can't tell you. All I can do is give you the best that I can. And hope that whatever it is we're doing here tonight has meaning to you in your own way. It's none of my business. it's only my business to respect all the talent that's in this room and do the work I can to you know, to bring it out in life. And I will stop speaking because we have much more music coming your way. We have the second world premiere of this evening just about to happen. Dr. Walker has done a marvelous job. Wait till you hear the choir. They're spectacular, as is everyone on this concert. And so we'll hear a new choral piece. Then we'll hear a solo clarinet piece, which was inspired by two things. The American idea that we are all individuals and that we operate as individuals, and Fred Astaire. Those are the two things that came into my head and became a clarinet piece, if you can believe that, you know. And then another a piece that I'll just say, it was a piece that I wrote in the early 1980s. It's amazing to me that 40 years later, you know, that I'm hearing the pieces, and I'm hearing them in a different culture than in 1983. But that piece was inspired by two things, many things. I'll just put them in your head. Maybe you think about them. Maybe it doesn't matter. But what was on my mind at the time was the Challenger, the explosion of the Challenger, which I saw with my own two eyes, not live, but on TV, which we think is live in our culture, you know. And the fact that I love speed. I really, really, really love to speed, you know. And in fact, I just, well, never mind. And that we do love speed as a culture. No, otherwise we wouldn't be, you know, saying that you win if you're a hundredth of a second faster than the next person. We really place a lot of value in speed. And the fact that I learned to drive in 1964 when the freeways were just being constructed. And my father, who had five daughters, decided that we should all learn to drive in a 1957 Thunderbird convertible. There's a lot there. But those are all the things that went into the last piece on this concert. Well, not all the things, but some of the inspiration for that piece, which is called Four on the Floor, Stick Shift in a Car. I hope you enjoy the second half. I'm so honored to be among you, and thank you for inviting me into your midst.
Don't get. Thank you. Yellow love. mock